We're going to see the infrastructure of the Pi system on a whiteboard today. So to start off with, you need to realize that every Pi system is pretty simple. There's three major components. First one is there's a Pi server. Now, the first thing to notice with a Pi server is that it's a piece of software. It's not a hardware. Often we'll look at a box and we'll be like, that's the Pi server. Well, not really. The Pi server is a piece of software that's on a Windows operating system, which is often Windows 2008. That's more like the actual machine. That's what that is. Elsewhere, we have another Windows operating system. And on there, we have something called the Pi interface. And lastly, we have Pi clients. So these are things like, let's say Pi clients. This is what actually provides you and your users with data, with graphs, with some kind of access to all the information and data that we've stored in the Pi server will come out in the clients. Things like Pi Data Link for spreadsheets in Microsoft Excel, Pi Process Book, Pi Coresight. And any kind of other data access we have to the Pi system. These are all ways to get data to users. So in the end here, we have people, because that's for the end goal here. We need our good people in our enterprise to be able to see the information they want. And be able to make decisions that are relevant to your business. And all of these are just pieces of software that will exist on their laptop or their personal computer, or in the case of Pi Coresight, are available over the web with just any web browser. But we also have to remember, where is the data coming from that they actually want to analyze? That comes from way over here on the left, from data sources. So data sources, I'm referring to here anything that makes some kind of process data that you want to see. Maybe it's a pump. A pump that turns on and off every day. And you just want to be able to see that through one of our tools. Or perhaps it's the temperature outside. Or maybe there's information in another database. That you want in the Pi system. Or maybe there's just manual measurements out there that you need to put in to the Pi system. These are all data sources. The role of these two pieces in the middle, which constitute the Pi system, is to get data from the data sources to the clients out there, the Pi clients, and then to your users, so that your users can see what's happening at the data source. And your users don't need to worry about all this stuff in the middle. So, the first step in this is that the language of the data here isn't necessarily friendly with the Pi server. It's in its own proprietary language. And there's lots of different pieces of equipment out there, and they all format their data in different ways. So the role of the Pi interface is to translate that data. Let's see here. We're going to use red for this. Translate that data into something that can be forwarded on to the Pi server and then stored away in a Pi archive. So now with this archive, we have a whole history of all the process data for as long as we've been recording it. And this is made possible by different Pi interfaces, each sending and translating the data and sending it to the Pi server. From there, the Pi server responds to queries from clients. So Data Link will say, hey, Pi server, I want to see the last 7 days of data for that pump. And the Pi server will serve out the data and show it to the user. That is a basic Pi system. There is a data source, which is not made by OSIsoft. It's a data source, which is contacted by an interface, which sends the data to a Pi server. And then there's just some way for the users to see the data. There's a whole lot of other things we add on to this. And most recently and most importantly, we have something called Pi AF. So I'm going to actually draw it in right here. We had this problem with the Pi server was really great at its job, and it still is really great at its job. But it's very machine-friendly. It communicates very well with a Pi interface and then stores away the data very robustly. However, for a user, sometimes looking at how we're storing the data is a little obscure. We're using very kind of technical computer-like names for the points of data that we're storing, and the organization of it is easy for a computer to understand and sort through, but not necessarily easy for a human. So now we have the Pi AF server. This provides a lot of things, but one of the things for the purposes of this exercise is that it is human-friendly. In exposing the organization of this data for the users, whereas the Pi server is more machine-friendly. For communicating with all these machines over here. And so now with Pi Processbook, Pi Coresight, Pi Data Link, we can see a human-friendly chart and organization of the data and still access all the process data over an entire history. And with this, we now have the basic Pi system. This is it. There's a server, there's an interface, there's clients, and there's something that's being recorded. And that's it. That's the basic Pi system.